bright duty. Every student matters.
Hello learners, welcome to your math lesson. Today we are going to learn about algebra, and in this particular lesson we will learn about the introduction to algebra. By the end of this lesson you will be able to understand what algebra is. Also you will learn about patterns and variables. Okay, so let us start to understand the introduction to algebra. There are so many branches in mathematics. We all know that the study of numbers is called as arithmetic. The study of shapes is called geometry. The study to use the letters and symbols in mathematics is referred to as algebra. And this is what we are going to cover today. As you can see here, it's written algebra. And do you see these sub branches that are written? Algebra can be exponential, it can be an expression, operation, slope, equations, trinomials, formula, inequality. All these things, they all come under the category of algebra. So it's a very, very broad topic that we are going to deal with. But however, it's just an introduction. So in this particular class, you will know what algebra is and how we are dealing with algebra. And in the future classes, you will learn more and more about it. It's very interesting and it's something very, very important in maths. So let us start with algebra. Right. So, algebra is a part of mathematics in which the letters and symbols are used to represent number in equations. So, in algebra, every time you will notice, you are going to deal with some equations where these equations have got some letters, some variables, some symbols, or even numbers definitely are involved. So, it helps you to study the unknown quantities. This is the use of your algebra. So, here it's an image given to you. They have equated x, that is a variable, okay, and a fixed number 17, and they are saying that x plus 17 is equal to 30, okay. So you see here the number 30, it is being equated to a number that is 17 and a variable x. So we will learn about variables more in this lesson. Let us move ahead. Now let us first understand what is a pattern, okay. Pattern, they are all around us, okay. If you see any design around you, every design is made by a pattern. If you even look at this flower, a flower that is around you, anywhere you see, the leaves that grow on a tree, the snowflakes that you see, everything has got a very beautiful pattern in them, right? So it is said that finding and understanding pattern gives you great power, okay. With patterns, we can learn to predict future, discover new things and better understand the world around us. And playing with patterns is definitely a fun. Why is it saying so? That just imagine, like, if you know a certain pattern, say I know that I was born in that particular year on day Monday, say, okay. So I can predict my future that in say in 2030, when will my birthday fall. So this is how I have learned the pattern. And then I can predict on which particular day my birthday will be, maybe the next year or maybe 10 years forward in the future. So this is how we have a very, if we have a very good understanding with patterns, we can have a great understanding of future as well. And even astronomers, they read the patterns and then they predict the future. So it's very interesting. Here you can see some examples in front of you. The first one is represented a very simple image. It's a coil kind of image, and as you can see that these so many things are all combined together, and the spiraled image that you see, it's just an example of a pattern. The next you see here, it's a pattern of dots, numbers. In the first this particular number, you see a single dot and it's written 1. Then the next one you see there are 3 dots and the number is written 3. Then the next one, you have got 6 and 6 dots are shown. So do you see every time they are trying to form a triangle with these numbers? I mean the number of dots. And these numbers 1, 3, 6, 10, 15, they are basically setting a pattern here. So it is maybe the number of dots required to form a triangle. Okay. So here they are trying to form equilateral triangles so that all the sides, they have got the same number of dots. So this is a type of pattern. Okay, we will learn more about this. And the third, you can see image. It's image of a carving that you might see in any building. If you see Akshardham temple, or if you see any Khajuraho temple, or any temple you think, or any archaeological, any big building that you think of, they have got these carvings done on the walls, right? On these carvings, you see they have made very small designs they have. And do you see how these designs, they are in a pattern? You will see that a same pattern is being followed. So same thing, they draw. Either they start from a very small and they make a big, something very similar, but it can vary in size. So all these are examples of patterns, okay? Now let us see patterns using matchsticks, okay? Now we are going to understand how we can write this particular pattern mathematically using the numbers and variables. And we are just starting with these matchsticks. As we have just seen the dots, we are going to form certain, as you can see these images of squares in front of you. Right? So we are going to see that if we are using matchsticks to form such squares, what pattern is observed while adding one more square to the pattern, okay? So look at the first one. We have got 1, 2, 3 and 4 matchsticks. So in order to make the first square, we are using 4 matchsticks. Now look at the next one. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, okay? In the first one, we required 4. In order to make 2 squares, now we are requiring 7. Let's see the next one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 it is. Right? So in order to make 1 square, 4 matchsticks. 2 squares, 7 matchsticks. 3 squares, 10 matchsticks. Do you see what is here? We have received a certain pattern. So here it says number of matchsticks used to make 1 square is 4, 2 squares is 7, 3rd square is 10. So now what pattern we have observed is, we are going to write it using the number and a variable. So the pattern here is 3n plus 1. Okay, let us understand this pattern. What is 3 here? 3 are the number of matchstick. Just imagine this particular first one, okay? In the first one, this is first matchstick, so 1, 2, 3, okay, and 3 plus 1, okay, just ignore this n for now, just imagine it is 3 plus 1, so how many matchsticks are there in the first one? It is 3 plus 1. Now look at the next one, okay, here we have got 1, 2, 3 and plus 1 and again 1, 2, 3, do you see the 1 that we have got? It is the same one here also. This particular line which is in middle, this one is same for both the squares, right? So now this n plays a role in here. What role is this n playing? See, if say we are working with the first square, so we will say it is 3n plus 1. And what is this n? N is the number of squares that we want to make. Listen to this carefully. What is n? N tells you the number of squares that you are making. So here in the first image, we have got 1 square. So in the first image, N equals to 1. So let us put this value of N in this. So it is 3 times 1 plus 1. So the answer is 4. So how many sticks are used in the first square? 4. Let's try this for the second one. Now we want to make 2 squares. So N equals 2. So this brings 3 times 2 plus 1. So 3 times 2 is 6 plus 1 is 7. Do you see now we are getting the right answer? Now say for the third image we have got 3 squares. So we'll put n equals to 3. This gives the value 3 times 3 plus 1. That is 9 plus 1 equals to, it equals to 10. Right? So this is how we have found a particular pattern to these squares which are formed by the matchsticks. Now it says with this pattern we can easily find the number of matchsticks required for any number of square. Okay? Let us see. They are asking you how many matchsticks will be used in 50th figure. So imagine you are making these squares 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. go on and on and on, and they want you to make till you make 50 such squares. And now they're asking you how many matchsticks will be required. So how will we do? Here the value of n is equal to 50, right? And in our pattern, what is the pattern? Let us write the pattern here. So here the pattern is 3n plus 1. Okay, where n we know we need to find for the 50th figure. So n equals to 50. So now putting the value of n in this, we get 3 times by 50 plus 1. I hope this is clear. So 3 times 50 is 150 plus 1 is equal to 151. So this is the number of matchsticks that will be required. So now if I ask you what will be the number of matchsticks required for 1000 such figures, so the value of n will be then 1000. Then you will do again 3n plus 1, and you will put for the value of n, you will put 1000. So it will be 3000 plus 1, that is 3001. Okay, so it's simple. I hope that you have understood how we can calculate the number of matchsticks for any figure. Because we know the pattern, we can calculate for any. Moving forward, it says the idea of a variable. Okay, now do you see that here in this forming, when you were forming this pattern, we basically used this particular letter n, right? And this n here, it can hold any value. This n, it can hold any value. Is that right? So what do we understand? We understand that we are using a particular method of a variable. And what is a variable? Variable refers to unknown quantities that can change or vary are represented using a lowercase in the English alphabets. Okay, so what is a variable? Variable is any unknown quantity which can have various amounts. You can put any particular value for that variable. Okay, so thus its name is variable, something that varies. I hope this much part is clear to you, how we are saying variable and how we are going to use such variables in order to find any number of something, just putting that particular variable into the pattern, that particular equation, expression that we are forming, right? Now, it says one such example that we have just discussed of the matchstick is 3n plus 1, where n is a variable, right? Now, here the value of n is unknown and it can vary from time to time, okay? Again, let's see, n is unknown and its value can vary. Like, if you remember, we first kept the value of n as 1, then we kept its value as 2, then 3, then we even kept its value as 50, and we have also seen that we can keep its value as 1000. And the fact is that you can put infinite many values for this particular value n. And what is this n? It's a variable. Okay, now moving ahead, and let us understand more examples of variables. Okay, it says we can use any letter as variables, but only lowercase English alphabets. This is very important. You can put the value of variable. You can name any variable. You can, as we have just used n, you can use x. This is a very common variable. You can use a, you can use y, x, y, z, anything. But make sure that you are using the alphabets in the lowercase. Okay, they cannot be a capital A. This is not a name that you can put for a variable. Okay, now it says numbers cannot be used as the variables as they have got a fixed value. You cannot put 1 as a variable. Okay, you cannot put 4 as a variable because 4 itself is a fixed value. Okay, it is a fixed value itself. We know that if we are talking about 4, we are talking about 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 such items. Okay, so it is fixed, right? So this can never be a variable. Okay, now they are saying they can also help to solve some other problems. So you will see that how simply using these patterns, you can solve several problems, right? Now it says that Kiran wanted to buy storybooks from a bookstore. She wanted to buy 3 books for herself, 2 for her brother, and 4 for 2 of her friends. Each book cost rupees 15. How much she should pay to the shopkeeper. Now let's see that this particular question, we can solve it easily. But what we are going to do, we are going to use the method that we have just learned, that is of variables. Okay, let us first calculate how much he needs to pay. So total, that the number of books that she wants. So let us write total number of books. So let's see how many books she's buying. Okay, so she's buying 3 books for herself, 2 books for her brother, and 4 books for 2 of her friends. Okay, so 4 for 2 friends. So it's just a single number, right? So now it's 3, 4, 5, then 6, 7, 8, and 9, right? So here let us write what is the total number of books. It is 9, right? So now what we need to do, it says that each book costs rupees 15. So let us write cost of each book is equal to rupees 15, right? So now we need to find how much she should pay to the shopkeeper. So amount paid. So if she has got 15 rupees cost is the cost of each book and she needs to buy 9 such books. So what is the simple method to do? We simply times the number of books by the cost of each book, right? So here let us do 9 times 15. So this is going to give us the amount for 9 books. So 9 times 15 is equal to 135. So this is the amount that she is going to pay to the shopkeeper. Now we have used a formal method. Now instead of this, let us see how we can calculate using the method of patterns to find number of books. Okay, so see here, the cost of one book, here it's written 1, the cost of one book is equal to 15, right? So if one book is 15 rupees, then 2 books will be 30 rupees, then 3 books will be 45 rupees, then 4 books will be 60 rupees. Do you see how we are just going on adding 5, 15, 15, 15 to each time? Now, if you go on and on and on, and here we have used a variable A to represent the number of books. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on till say N, or you can use A, any variable, just needs to be a small variable. So then because we are just keep on adding 15 every time, so from 15 to 30, 30 to 45, 45 to 60, we are just adding 15 every time. So what are we basically doing? If we think about any number A, so we are just jumping a big number, what will we do? We will times 15 by A. If suppose you want to calculate the amount for 2, what do? You times 2 by 15. If you want to calculate for 4, what do? You times 4 by 15. As you have just calculated here, that what is the amount she needs to pay for when it was 9 books. You simply multiply 9 by 15. So what do? We times the number with the cost of each book, right? So what pattern do we get? The pattern that we have got is 15A, that is 15 times by A. Now with using this, you can calculate any number that you want. For example, if you want to know that what will be the cost of 100 books. So for 100 books, that means A equals to 100. So what do? We simply put the value of A in the pattern, that is 15 times by 100. So she needs to pay then 1500 rupees. Clear? Let's move ahead. Now let's write the expression for this particular statement. It says Manu has 2 erasers more than Tanu. Okay, we are talking about 2 people here. Okay, so let us write some variables for them. Let number of erasers with Manu is equal to X. Okay, so let the number of erasers with Manu be X. Now the question says that Manu has 2 more erasers than Tanu. So we have no idea how many erasers Manu have. We have got no idea how many erasers Tanu have. But what we know is that whatever Tanu is having, Manu is having 2 more than that. Okay. So now let us write number of erasers with Tanu. Right. So if Mannu is having two erasers more than Tanu, so what will be the number of erasers with Tanu? It will be whatever amount Mannu is having, she'll be having two less than that. I hope this makes sense. Mannu has two erasers more than Tanu. So here we have written, let the erasers with Mannu be X. So what will be Tanu having? She'll having whatever Mannu is having, just two less than that. Or else what we can write this, let us say, I'm just writing, you can solve this question in whatever way you like to write it. Say, if I write, let number of erasers with Tanu be X. So now we are assuming that let, here I can put a line. This is one expression that we have made. Now we are making another expression, and this time we have assumed that let the number of erasers with Tanu be X. Okay, so then the number of erasers with Mannu is X plus 2, because he was having 2 more than what Tanu was having. I hope this is clear. So you can form the expression, you can change a particular expression depending upon what you have chosen as your variable and how you are putting that into the expression. Let's read the next one. It says Raju and Ravi are brothers. Ravi is younger than Raju by 3 years. When Raju is 12 years, Ravi is 9 years. When Raju is 15 years, Ravi is 12 years. Form an expression to represent the situation. Okay, so let us first form a table here for what information we are given. Okay, so let me write here for Ravi, and here I am writing for Raju. It says Ravi is younger. Okay, so he is younger than Raju by 3 years. Okay. So first of all, this is the main statement that is going to help us to form the pattern. Let us see what more information is given, okay? So it says when Raju is 12, Ravi is 9 years old. Okay? It says when Raju is 15, Ravi is 12 years old. Let us form an expression for them, okay? Let's say that Raju is X years old. Okay, let it be X years old. Here what variable I'm using? X. Then because Ravi is younger than Raju by 3 years, so if Raju is 15, he's 3 less, Ravi is 3 less, so he's 12. Now when Raju is 12, Ravi is 3 less, that is 9. So if here I have made X as the variable for the age of Raju, what will be the age of Ravi? It will be X minus 3. Is this simple? Right? So what pattern do we have here? The pattern that we see in their ages is X minus 3. So whatever the age of Raju is, we have assumed this as with the variable X, Ravi will be 3 years less, that is X minus 3. Right?